that's a legit question. Thanks for the call. Is it safe to admit or to assume that Tim Murray had to have been in on this in some way, shape, or form? Does Adam Larson have a higher ceiling than Zach Bogosian?
Maybe right now. Adam Larson, I think Edmonton feels that Adam Larson is going to develop into a number 2-3 defenseman. If he can develop his game into a 2-3 defenseman, I don't think it's still trade one on one. How would you try to get Hall here? 803-0558-8550-2550. How would you try to get him? Would it have taken the Gozer? Would you have done that? Would you have been given more? What would have been your offer to Chiarelli in order to try and get Taylor Hall? Or do you think they should have maybe let Taylor Hall go and really try to leave your core pieces as is, and don't try and get somebody in free agency, try and get somebody that can help your team in a way, in other ways that Taylor Hall maybe doesn't. I'm trying to think about all different solutions here, but Hall made a great point. Like, Hall had enough to get Taylor Hall. Whether it's Bogosian or whatever, they had enough to get Taylor Hall. Should they have been able
to? These trades come out, and I shake my head with that story. And in the sense that I believe that we have the people, we have the players, we have the draft picks, and I think that we should have acquired Taylor Hall. And, it's frustrating when you sit there and look at a 1-to-1 trade, you're trading a number 1 bona fide superstar that scores 30-plus goals every year for a defenseman that scored 2 goals last year at 18 points. And they're hoping that he's going to be a number 1, 2, or 3. Well, you're hoping?
So that wasn't even the biggest news of the day. That was a big deal, and I think the biggest news in that deal was the robbery, we'll say right now, that was involved. So it seems right now. But the biggest news yesterday for me, the rumors about PK Subban were obviously true, but nowhere did I ever see or think or hear or whatever that Shea Weber was true.
Well, again, who do you think won this game?
I don't think there's I hate this winning game because I see it too. I can go two very, very different ways. PK Subban is a $9 million cap hit until 2021. So he has 6 years left. And Shea Weber is a 7.87 something million.
Yeah, 7.8 for the next 10 years.
That's his cap hit.
Both extremely high-end defense. As good as you're going to get. When we talk about number 1 defenseman in the league, you could arguably say that there's 12, maybe 15 number 1 defensemen. Well, these two guys are number 1. And PK Subban, who is 27 years old, is 4 years younger. This is where it gets tricky. If he's 4 years younger than Shea Weber. And Shea Weber has a 10-year contract. A 10-year contract. That's where the numbers get skewed. I think people are out there saying, why did you trade PK Subban? And I think that Montreal is wanting a fresh start. I think I shouldn't say baggage, but what comes along with PK Subban and his bigger than life, personality, which I think is great, but I think it wears in the dressing room. Not for the fans, it wears in the dressing room. And they've brought in literally one of the greatest captains and one of the best defensemen in the league in Shea Weber. And I think that they, you look at what they've brought in. They brought in Andrew Shaw, and now they
everybody's showrunner, you know the direction they're going. They want players that have that heart and determination.
They just got Sergachev in the draft.
Sergachev in the draft. They're looking for players that play team hockey, that are willing to do anything to win. And, you know, Shea Weber's a great player. So is PK Subban, but it just comes down to the length of the contract and the age of the hockey player.
Well, personally, I think I look at Shea Weber, and I think he really has five really good years. And if you look at his contract here, I'm looking right at it. Nashville would have had to pay him something that I think they may have already done. It's like $8 million signing. And next year, whereas PK Subban this year, next year is $2 million. The other thing is, Shea Weber has four or five really good years left in Montreal, which is where it should take Montreal if they're serious about winning with people with Gordon Price being on.